What up, everybody? This is Brett here, and today we're doing another review, but today we're starting my WWF pay-per-view review, starting in the year we're going to start with the year I was born, which is 1995, and we're going to watch from the very first one, the Royal Rumble, all the way up through. We're going to try to drop these every other week, so twice a month you will have one of these. Of course, follow all my socials and everything down below in the description. And before we get started, comment down below if you like this pay-per-view. Anything I can do better, then of course subscribe, like, and all that jazz. So let's get started with my overall thoughts of the pay-per-view. I thought it was a good pay-per-view. They did a good job telling the stories that needed to be told and setting things up they needed to set up in this Royal Rumble pay-per-view for WrestleMania 11, which is where Bam Bam takes on Lawrence Taylor of the New York Giants in the main event. They set all the matches up for that WrestleMania in this Royal Rumble. A lot of them were set up. So let's get to the breakdown of match by match what I thought. First off, we start off with the Intercontinental Championship match. Your champion at the going into this match was Razor Ramon, the Bad Guy, taking on that slap nuts himself, Jeff Jarrett, with the Roadie in his corner. This was a good match. I'd give it 3 out of 5. I really enjoyed it. Jeff worked over Razor's leg to the point where he couldn't even stand, so the ref had to stop the match. Jeff challenges Razor challenges his masculinity, his machismo. Razor comes back out, which costs him the match overall. So, that was one thing I really enjoyed about that match, was that it told a story throughout the whole thing. Razor's leg, Razor's leg, Razor's leg. And it did end up costing him the match, with obviously help of the Roadie, Road Dog Jesse James, later to be known. So let's get to match number 2, which was The Undertaker with Paul Bearer in his corner, taking on Erwin R. Scheister. And in this match, we have Erwin R. Scheister, IRS, also had Ted DiBiase in his corner. This match was a boatload of interferences. Everybody interfered in the match, which was a theme in this pay-per-view, especially in the next match as well. But we're not there yet. We'll continue talking about this match. So this was at the point where Undertaker started to sell a little bit as The Undertaker, but not really selling, as you would see him later on in his career. Erwin tried to beat him down. They even got druids to help run interference to beat The Undertaker down. That didn't even help. Match ended with Undertaker chokeslamming IRS to the mat for a 1-2-3. But then gets jumped by the druids afterwards. He holds his own. Then King Kong Bundy comes out and attacks him, which sets up their WrestleMania match that year. And Undertaker can barely roll out of the ring. And I give that match a 2.5 out of 5 due to all the interferences. But I did like the ending in it all. So let's get to match number 3 of the card. And that is the WWF Championship match, where you have the champion going into this, Big Daddy Cool Diesel, taking on the Hitman Bret Hart. No, I'm not named after him. I spell my name with 2. He spells his with 1. So, match starts off well and good. Really good match working through it all. They talk about how Bret's became more aggressive throughout the whole match. And you see it on display. He's really attacking Diesel's knee, trying to take his knee out. At one point, Diesel hits the jackknife. You think it's over. Shawn Michaels comes out, super kicks him. And that was one thing that annoyed me, is like, they didn't stop the match. They got Shawn out of there, and then they continued it the whole time. I was like, what the hell? And then later on in the match, Brett's got Diesel in a sharpshooter. And then Owen attacks Brett, which also sets up their WrestleMania match. But what the hell? Doesn't stop the match. If this, in today's day and age, that's 2 disqualifications. The match is over with. at this point. And then the way the match ends is Shawn Michaels, Double J, Rhodey come out and attack Diesel, and then Owen and Bob Backlund come out and attack Brett, which basically makes the refs call it a no disqualification, a draw. Oh, one thing I did forget to mention in the previous match was that I didn't like how Undertaker was just sitting up constantly doing his comeback, sitting up, sitting up, sitting up. And I know that's part of the whole jar thing that Paul Bearer does, but I didn't like it. I kind of like how they did it later on, where it was one time a match, boom, and it was his comeback. But other than that, like I said, they were setting things up for the WrestleMania coming up. That's what the Royal Rumble usually was for, is to set things up coming up forward, which I said I really enjoyed. But nope, that match, I give it a 2 out of 5 because of all the interferences and stuff just not being called. And then we get to the tag team match, which is the cool down match, or as people like to say, the bathroom match, which was 123 Kid and Bob Holly, NASCAR racer Bob Holly, taking on Tatanka and Bam Bam Bigelow from Ted DiBiase's faction, which I thought was really cool, as they had another faction of Ted DiBiase, another match for Ted DiBiase's faction, which they ended up losing that match. They had the whole match under control because basically they were just beating up the 123 Kid, and then they beat up Bob Holly when he got tagged in too. They really used Bam Bam's size as a thing in this match, which I thought was cool. But the way it ends is Bam Bam's going for his splash. He misses it. He just goes face first into the mat. And it was 1, 2, 3. Bob Holly and 123 Kid win that match. And it was also said that the Guns, Billy, and James Bart Gunn weren't in the match due to them having a rodeo accident, which was weird because they were in the Royal Rumble later on. But needless to say, that's the tag match. That was fun. I'd give it 3 out of 5. I was entertained the whole time. And let's get to the Royal Rumble match. In the match kicks off with Shawn Michaels versus the British Bulldog, in which they both go the whole length of the distance, which I don't think a lot of people talk about, is the fact that they both went the length of the distance in the Royal Rumble match. They both came out at 1-2 and they finished 1-2. A fun stipulation for this match was the winner gets to not only get a WWF title shot, but gets Pam Anderson to walk them down, which they had shots of her all night. And King was saying how they're going out later that night and all that. One thing about the tag match previous that I forgot to mention is that this is where they set up Bam Bam Bigelow versus Lawrence Taylor for the main event of WrestleMania 11. So, like I said, back to this Royal Rumble match, Shawn and Bulldog come out 1-2, and they make it the whole way. The one takeaway from this match I have overall is that this match was a bunch of jobbers. There wasn't a lot of big stars like we'll see in 2 years, where you have the ascension of Stone Cold, where you'll still have Bret Hart around and Diesel's Razor Ramon. Nobody from the previous matches were in the Royal Rumble match, which were all their big name stars. So you had like the Blues Brothers, they didn't even hear of them, they were eliminated quickly. One of the cool aspects of this Rumble I did like, though, was Lex Luger was the one who eliminated all the big men from the match. Like, you had King Kong Bundy, you had Mabel, and you had Mantar. Mantar was kind of cool looking, I'm not gonna lie, I thought he was cool looking. But needless to say, Luger was the giant guy who took out all the giants. Shawn basically, he eliminated maybe one or two people the whole match and basically just went from corner to corner getting beat up. This really shows how good of a wrestler he really was at that time, his ability to sell and just move around the ring. You would see like young Billy Gunn in this match. You'll see a lot of younger, you'll see the Bushwhackers were another tag team that was in there. You see a lot of younger wrestlers who you'll see 5 years down the road, not even 3 to 4 years down the road, who are in the main event scene or upper mid card scene of WWF in this, which I thought was kind of cool. Like you see a young Rikishi, he's in this as well. I can't think of another big name they had in there was like Bob Backlund and Owen Hart, which I thought was real cool. But other than that, they didn't really have that many big names. And Owen and Brett were Owen and Bob were taken out by Brett. They basically came in and then got eliminated. You did have some fun names in there, like Deuce the Dumpster Drozzi was in it. He made it to the final five, or final four. Yeah, sorry, the final four. Or I can't believe I can't remember if it was the final four or final five, but he made it very long in the match. And then you had the Head Shrinkers. They were in it. You had the Bushwhackers. It is kind of like a little fun no name, but you clearly saw who they wanted to win that year, and that was Sean or the British Bulldog, because they both won. They made it to the very end, but they also started, and that's all they ever talked about. Oh, and King Kong Bundy was in it. He got eliminated by Luger as well. Luger made it to the final three, but then gets eliminated. No, sorry, this is how it goes. Dumpster was five. He gets eliminated by Luger. Luger gets eliminated by Crush and Sean. And then Crush and Sean try to beat up on the Bulldog, but Sean turns on him, eliminates Crush, and then you have Bulldog and Sean in the finals. Bulldog thinks he eliminates Sean, but this is the one where he only gets 1 foot, touches the ground, and swings his legs all the way back up, rolls back in the ring, and eliminates the Bulldog for him to win, which now sets up Sean versus Diesel, which we saw earlier in the pay-per-view, get set up. Funny thing is, though, yes, Sean wins this match, but if you go watch WrestleMania 11, which I will be doing for the next wrestling review here, he did not come down with Pam Anderson. He came down with Jenna McCarthy instead, which I think is kind of funny. But if you see the way he acted at the end of the Royal Rumble, doing his like little dance he does and everything, kind of looked like he made her feel a little uncomfortable. But so I could see that maybe why she didn't want to go down with him, walk him down to the aisle. But other than that, I thought overall it was a fun pay-per-view to watch. I would definitely recommend if you got nothing going on, like on the weekends or something. Yeah, check this pay-per-view out. I thought it was real fun. Like I said, comment down below what you guys think of this, and like, follow for more. Okay, bye.